The human gut serves not only for digestion, but also as a very active part of the immune system. The gut is home to many of the body's CD4-positive T cells, the main type of cell that HIV infects and destroys. During the early stages of infection, HIV mounts a severe and prolonged attack on the gut, depleting these T cells. Typically, CD4-positive T cells are directed to and retained in the gut through the action of a protein on their surfaces called alpha-4-beta-7 integrin. When stimulated, T cells produce high levels of alpha-4-beta-7. The cells circulate through the blood. When the circulating T cells reach very small blood vessels called venules in the gut, alpha-4-beta-7 on the cell surface interacts with a protein called MADCAM-1. The interaction with MADCAM-1 directs the T cell into the gut's immune tissues. Scientists from the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, or NIAID, found that alpha-4-beta-7 also is present on the surface of HIV itself. When HIV infects a T cell, it uses the cell's machinery to produce new viral genetic material and proteins. These newly produced viral components move to the perimeter of the cell, where immature HIV begins to form. Once assembled, the new virus buds off from the cell, taking a piece of the cell membrane with it to form the viral membrane, or envelope. The NIAID researchers found that when HIV buds from a T cell producing alpha-4-beta-7, it carries the integrin along and incorporates it into its envelope. As with T cells bearing alpha-4-beta-7, HIV bearing this protein is directed into the immune tissues in the gut through the interaction of alpha-4-beta-7 with MADCAM-1. In this way, HIV hijacks the cellular protein alpha-4-beta-7 to home to the gut and establish infection in this organ system, which harbors one of the richest populations of HIV target cells in the body.